All right. Hey, what's up? It's Keith. In this video, I want to talk about how to go from being flat broke and struggling and feeling unworthy of success and maybe even being depressed. How to go from that to the opposite, which is feeling absolutely worthy in many, many ways. Pardon me, it's a late night. Oh, look at that. That's called plowing snow days on end with no sleep and then doing everything, and I love it. But anyways, I like to go out and do late grocery shopping. This is going to be a really real video, like super real stuff. So if you're struggling financially, and I'm not talking to you guys that are making plenty of money, because I'm talking to you if you're financially struggling and what type of toll that can play on your mind and your heart and your emotions. Like I said, 6 years ago, I had lost my $15 an hour landscape job and literally ended back up at a $10 and then a $9.50 per hour lawn care job at the age of 27 years old. I was a grown-ass man. I lost everything. I had gotten sued. I had a full-blown nervous breakdown. It wasn't full-blown. It was like a nervous breakdown for sure, though. I had lost everything, and I couldn't take it. I looked in the mirror at myself, and I was like, I'm 27. I'm supposed to be this smart guy who's read all these books and is such a hard damn worker. Man, I can't believe I'm a fucking loser, man. I couldn't handle it, and I had fallen in love with my wife at that time, too, and there was no way out. I was going to end up sleeping on couches and lose the woman of my dreams. And I snapped. I went crazy. That's how I started my business. That's how I started window cleaning. That's how I started all of it. And I'm talking like on a shoestring. I was this close from losing everything, dangled in the mouth of Satan, like an alligator pit. That's the way I look at it, like dangled inside of a volcano. That's the only way I could look at it. So I'll tell you a quick story. I'm in a department store a few minutes ago, grabbing a couple things. It's late night. I'm going home now. But there's this stock people working. And one guy looked particularly sharp. He looked my age. And I said, hey man, how much you guys get paid an hour? He's like, you know, $9.50 to start. You can get $10 an hour if you take a bunch of tests. I go, really, how many hours per shift, you know? He goes, 7 hours per shift. It's 8 hours, hour lunch, and then 4 shifts a week. That's how many, 4 nights a week. So it's 32 hours a week at $9.50 an hour after taxes. I'm like, dude, that's like $300 a week. After taxes, like $250. You get paid every 2 weeks, right? And I'm thinking to myself, I'm like, oh my God, I make that in a day. I wouldn't even go out for less than that in a day, right? Well, I would do anything, you know, but what I'm saying is that, and it hit me like a ton of bricks that 6 years ago, that was me. 6 years ago, I looked in my own eyes in the mirror, and I had lost everything.
Is this recording?
Yeah. And I went to just leave, and I look back, I'm like, the guy that worked there, I said, you know, to myself, I go, dude, I can't leave him back there. That's me back there, stocking those shelves. That's me back there. And the guy looked like kind of depressed. He looked trapped in that dead end job. And I could see when I talked to him, he didn't believe he could get out. He believed that was his life, and he had accepted it. He became, what's the word, not incarcerated, but when you were in prison and you become institutionalized, so to speak, accepted his fate. And I went to ring up, I'm like, whatever, it's none of my business. I'm just being weird, I'm out at night, and I'm looking too deep into people. It's none of my business. And I'm like, no, dude, fuck that. And I couldn't help myself. I was pacing around the aisles, and I walked back up to the dude. And he looks at me, he's like, here you go again, this is fucking weird. I'm like, listen, dude, I don't know you from shit. I just want to tell you something. He goes, what's that? look him dead in his eyes, I said, 6 years ago, I had lost everything. I was flat broke and bawling my eyes out in a basement. And I had met the woman of my dreams, which I'm married to, you know, today. And I looked in the mirror at the age of 27 and I said, I can't believe I'm a grown ass man and I'm fucking broke. I'm fucking nowhere. I'm a nobody. And I said I had a breakdown, man. And I went crazy and I started, landscaping and cleaning windows, anything. And I blew up an entire, you know, small business out of being completely desperate. And today I'm moderately successful and I can't believe it. I can't accept it that it worked. I can't accept it. And I just... And the guy looked at me, and that whirr in his eyes, whatever that was, like the daze, it went away. Like it pulled the veil up, and he looks at me, he goes, wow, that's so crazy. You just came up to me and said that. He goes, I'm going through the same thing right now. Because I said to him, I said, there's something called the dark night of the soul. It's where you go through this period, this dark period in your life, this dip, where your life is just fucking horrible. There's nothing you can do about it, and you're trapped. And you feel like you're never gonna get out. It's a very dark period in your life. He said, that's crazy, that's what I'm going through. I lost everything, and I was just living in my mom's basement, and I just found out that his fiance or girlfriend, they're gonna have a baby. And he's like, now he's working two jobs. He's working all day, working all night at these two dead-end jobs, and he's 30 years old. And I just looked at him, I said, dude, I want to tell you something. And I'm not trying to be hokey pokey, and I know you don't know me, but you deserve whatever you want, dude. It's the environment that tells you you can't, but you deserve to make a lot of money. You deserve to have whatever you want. And it's like, I don't know, I just felt like I can't leave that guy there. That's my brother. I love, and I left, man, and I almost cried because I love people so much. I love people. I want to see people do good. I know what it feels like to be down and out. I know what it feels like. And I know that any minute, if I can say, I'm not afraid to say, any minute God can take it all away. You put me right back there. And if you got money, dude, or you got things in your life that are good, dude, you screw up or you don't appreciate it, it can all be taken away from you in a second. I've had shit taken away from me so many times that you learn that lesson to, like, stay a narrow track. And I learned that in this book, Outwitting the Devil by Napoleon Hill, that drifters, don't drift in your consciousness. Stay focused. Stay extremely focused and centered. Focused, and don't let anything throw you off track. It's almost like a type of paranoia. I can't explain it, but it keeps the success coming. That it's a definiteness of purpose. You feel that right there? That's what will get you out of your hole. It's definiteness of purpose right there. Don't let depression overcome you. Don't let drifting overcome you. Please don't let any addictions overcome you. And please stay definite in your purpose, and you will get out of the hole and you'll stay out of the hole. It's a very specific type of emotion. It's a very specific frequency, so to speak. It's boom. Right there. That's what keeps the energy flowing, the good energy in your life. The bad energy is when you feel down and depressed and you just feel like you're not worthy, and you're like you're wishing and praying for bad things to come into your life. You're not even aware you're freaking doing it. You're not even aware that you're broke, and you're not even aware that you're struggling and suffering because you're letting it and allowing it into your life. You're allowing those cancers into your life instead of banishing them out. You know what I mean? Bam! You banish them out. Like, literally, I come from somewhat of a religious family. My godfather, Mike, is awesome, and he told me, go around your house and open up all the windows and banish any bad energies out. He calls them demonic energies or demons. Things can attach themselves to you, energies, spirits, whatever you want to call it. I believe in some real deep stuff that I don't talk about on my YouTube channel. I don't talk about it because, not that I'm ashamed of it. at all. It's because I want to touch people and speak to people and relate to people. But I just want to say, if you got anything attached to you, you have the power and you have the right to demand it out of your life. Whoever, maybe it's a person, maybe it's an energy, maybe it's an emotion or a spirit or an addiction, and you have the power to get that thing out of your life. And the thing that's stopping you is believing that you don't have the power, is believing you're helpless to it and letting it run you up. Don't let the demons run you up. You run them down and demand them and shoo them out of your life, whatever those are. You objectify your demons. So when you go through it, you say, there it is again. No. I could just start yelling right now and just getting crazy, but I'm not going to. So I just want to let you know that if you're going through shit, you can get out of it. And if it feels unstoppable and you're powerless to it, and it feels like it's like all over you, this chaos, this drama, this energy, but Keith, you don't understand my situation. Dude, I do understand your situation. Don't tell me I don't. Don't tell me I don't understand your situation. Don't tell me that you're special, that your situation is worse, and you don't have any way out of it. Don't tell me that you can't get out of your fucking situation. Don't tell me you can't, because you can, and you gotta believe that you can so deeply down inside that you can grow out of it. If there's people you have to cut off or temporarily, whatever that may be, to grow up and get out of it, it's very difficult and complex when you're in the hole, though, and you have drama all around you. I know what it feels like. It's a deep inner belief that has to be so strong. It's a dream that you have to feed that dream every single day and say, I know these people around me are fucking crazy. I know my situation sucks. I know I'm in a hole. I know I have this outside force pressing down upon me, but I have a dream deep down inside that it's an inner candle flame that never flickers. Let me say that again. It's an inner flame that never flickers, no matter what. It's that, like when Dr. Viktor Frankl was on the deathbed in the Nazi concentration camps, like, you can torture me, you can take everything from me, but you can't take my spirit, you can't take my heart, you can't take what's inside, you can't take my pride, you can't take my dignity, and you can't take my honor away. You can't take that away from a man unless he gives it to you, unless he lets it go. Don't let anybody or anything or any energy or anyone take away your dignity or your pride. Not someone in a relationship, not someone who is, let's just say, treats you like crap or is abusive in some way to you, or any energy or any system, take away that inner candle flame. Because once you let that go, dude, and your head drops, you're done, you're toast. It's very hard to get back out. It's very hard to climb out of that hole if you allow yourself to fall in it. And I'm going to say there's a difference between that and hitting rock bottom. Sometimes hitting rock bottom can be good, because that's when you really, really can, you get like shocked out of yourself and you wake up to the realities. But also facing your brutal reality is one of the hardest things you can do in your life, to actually look in the mirror and face, all right, dude, I messed up, or I'm a mess up, or I've been lying to myself. Deception is crazy because it covers its own tracks. You don't know you're doing it. You can't even look at it. It's a blind spot. And to face it is like facing the devil. If you get to the point where you're running through the labyrinth of the darkest basement inside of you, and you're chasing down the devil with a flashlight, the ego, you can't shine light on it because it runs and it hides in the dark. It dwells in the darkness from the dark places. And in those dark places, it runs you up and it manipulates you and it blinds you and it keeps you in suffering and stupidity. When you look at the ego, you can't see it. It's like an entity. It is the alter ego of you that is hooked to earthly things. I know I sound like I'm preaching or something, but I've seen this, man. I've seen it. And when I locked myself in that basement 6 years ago and I had a breakdown, I said, I'm not coming out of this basement till I'm changed. I'm serious. Like, I cried on the floor. I cried so hard blood was coming out of my nose. And I bared down on my ego and my consciousness. And I bared down on it. And I bared down on it. And it kept running. And I said no. And when I got it to 99% gone, I shined the light on it. Inside of this, I really, this was a spiritual revelation. 1% was still hiding. That little 1% was still hiding back there. Like when you pull weeds or something, if there's one little root, it'll come all the way back. I said, I will not even live another moment until this is gone and ripped out of me and I am a changed man. And I bared down and I was bawling my eyes out and I was screaming and I was crying and I was like crazy. I'm serious. Like I could go into it right now, but I'm not going to. I'm talking the hardest you've ever cried in your life times three. Just sobbing to rip it out, to rip it out, to take that like almost like a possession and get it out of you, that denial out, until I was completely purified. That's how deep it is. And when you become purified by walking through the fire, then you can let go of your iniquities. You can let go of the things that are holding you back. You can finally be free of whether it be the addictions to the ego, the addictions to a whole list of things, or an extremely codependent relationship, which needs to be healed. But first you have to heal inside. First look in the mirror and be healed. First look at yourself. You can't change the world or other people. You can only change yourself. And the ego wants to deny that. I just want to tell you, man, even if I don't know you personally, and I know, like, when I went to the GIE Expo, it was so awesome. I met so many cool people. Look at me dead in my eyes. Say, what up, Keith? Like, you guys know me. You know me because you watched me on the videos. You know the real me. This is the real me, okay? And I want to let you know that even though I don't know you personally, I still know you. And you are my brother, and I care about you. I care about you so much, you don't even know how much I care about you. You have no idea how much I care about you. I swear on everything. I swear right now, I care about you so much. And I believe in you more than you ever know. And I believe in you more than you believe in yourself. If you're depressed and you're going through shit, I fucking believe in you, man. I believe in you. I want you to... I want you to define your dream and crystallize it. Hold it in your hand so clearly that you can just see it and smell it and touch it, and taste it. And go out and fucking get that shit, dude. Get it, because you deserve it. You deserve it, okay? But. Just go get it. It's going to be hard. It's going to be a shit storm. Because when you actually start chasing your dream and you make the decision, oh, that's when it gets really fucking bad, dude. Dude, I've been through hell. Not like third world countries starving to death, okay, for the United States. I've legitimately been through hell, dude. I don't like to complain, but so I'm 32 now. I've been to 13 different schools. I lived in 33 different homes. We've lived in homeless shelters when I was a kid. My mother, if you know, she died from a heroin overdose. My sister found her with a needle in her arm. I've been around drugs and alcohol and toxicity. I've slept on couches. I ran away when I was 14. I mean, I'm talking, I've slept in my car when I was a kid. My mother and I, we lived in homeless shelters and slept in her car. We were legitimately fucking poor. And stuff like that, you know? And I've been through a lot of hell. So I know what it's like, okay? So I'm qualified to talk about this shit. Alright. I gotta go, man. This is a long, crazy video. I'm uploading it to YouTube, dog. Alright. Later.